Ben Greenfield, it's so exciting to have you here. Thank you for making the time.
Thanks for having me.
So you talk about a lot of things, and I'm fascinated to learn what got you into this place where you're obsessed with health, you're obsessed with biohacking your own biology. When did this all begin?
My story is really boring. I was never morbidly obese. I never had a horrible chronic disease. Like I have just always loved studying and deciphering and decoding the human body.
The majority of people are either overweight or obese. Diabetes is at, what, like 50%? There's so many crazy statistics, and they're not going in the right direction. What are we doing wrong?
You know what? I think the number one thing that goes wrong when it comes to fat loss, and you could say the same thing about health in general, but especially like body composition.
Yes.
It's that we see the headlines, like, eggs are bad for you, eggs are good for you. The low-carb, high-fat diet gives you heart disease. The low-carb, high-fat diet saves your heart. You know, low-intensity, steady-state cardio before breakfast is the best way to lose fat. Saving your hard workout for the end of the day is the best way to lose fat. And it confuses people, and it's understandable, but the reason that it confuses people is because the truth is everybody's wired differently, right? My blood, my biomarkers, my genetic predispositions to respond to certain exercises, my nutrient deficiencies, everything is different from person to person. Don't get me wrong, there are universal principles that apply.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah, let's say, for example, something that not a lot of people are talking about, in my opinion, or not enough people are talking about, this concept of glycemic variability, right? Like, how often does your blood glucose fluctuate during the day? Not only is that because blood glucose fluctuations have a profound effect on, you know, how many of those glucose molecules get shoved into fat tissue, but it also has a profound effect on inflammation, on chronic disease risk factors. I mean, if you could control your blood sugar, in my opinion, in addition to controlling inflammation, that's one of the best things that you can do for general health and for fat loss. Like, how can you limit the number of times that your blood sugar rises during the day, how many fluctuations that you experience. Lowering glycemic variability is not rocket science.
It is such a pleasure and such an honor to be able to learn from you and all of your exploration and insight and guidance. I mean, I think you've helped millions of people. It's awesome. Incredible.
Awesome. Well, thanks for having me on. I'm honored.